Hello and welcome to this tutorial. As you may have heard, Blender recently released a new version, the Blender version 2.75. It has a number of new features. One of the most exciting features, which I've been waiting for a long time, is the possibility to render stereoscopic images and movies. This tutorial will show you how to do this. I've prepared a simple scene for this. There is a plane, some 3D text, a cube, and an icosphere. First, activate Stereoscopy in Blender. This is done by selecting Render Layer from the menu. And then, under View, selecting Stereo 3D. If we now switch to the camera view, we see that Stereoscopy already works. Next, the 3D monitor must be set for the scene. As we are working in 3D, it is important to have a way to see 3D. And this can be done by selecting Window, Set Stereo 3D. Note that when Views is not enabled, this menu item is not visible. Therefore, Views must be activated first, and then you can see the menu item Stereo 3D. For the 3D monitor, there are a range of options: top-bottom, side-by-side, time-sequential, interlace, and anaglyph. I have, for example, an interlaced 3D monitor, row interleaved. Here, you can also swap the left and right images. But for this tutorial, we will use anaglyph with red sign. Next, the camera must be set. Here, under the menu item Stereoscopy, you can display the left camera, the right camera, or both of them. In addition, there is the possibility to switch on the 3D view for both cameras, the screen plane, and the save volume. The next settings we find under the camera icon. Here you can choose between the various methods for the stereoscopic camera: off axis, parallel, and toe-in. Since toe-in and parallel are normally only used in exceptional cases, and off-axis is the better method, we will use off-axis in this tutorial. Here, two things can be chosen: the convergence point, and also the distance between the cameras. With parallel and toe-in, only the distance between the cameras can be selected. With the first point convergence plane distance, you set where the 3D objects are in relation to the screen plane. That means, if we set the screen plane here, then the 3D text is in front of the screen. And the cube and the icosphere are behind the screen plane. If we set the screen plane behind the cube, then both the cube and the 3D text are in front of the screen plane. And the icosphere is behind the screen plane. The second menu item, interocular distance, is used to set the distance between the two cameras. The more the distance is increased, then the greater is the depth effect in the scene. That means, when there is a large distance between the cameras, then there is an increased depth effect. And when there is a small distance between the cameras, there is a decreased depth effect. It is important to note that when there is a large distance between the cameras, a so-called ghosting can appear, which is best removed by again adjusting the distance of the cameras. In the render view, you can at any time switch between the 3D view and the normal view. And also display the left and right image. For the stereoscopic rendering, the same applies as for the normal rendering. You select whether you want to render either a video or image sequence. And then you can decide whether you want to render either individual images for the left camera and the right camera, or, as sometimes can be useful, a stereo image such as a red, blue anaglyph image. The anaglyph 3D image, for example, can be used to quickly check the 3D effect of a scene. And the left and right images can be further processed, for example, for animation or a movie. So, that wraps up our brief overview over stereoscopic work in Blender. If you like this tutorial, you can subscribe to our channel or you can look at our other videos. Otherwise, see you next time.